Welcome everybody to Adarha. My name is Damien. Welcome also to Global Wellness Day. This is a really unique event that we're really proud to be a part of. It's celebrated with over 7,000 events and over 150 countries. And it's punctuated by a particular day, which is the second Saturday, the 12th of June in this year. And that'll be a 12-hour live stream event. So we're proud to be kind of kicking things off here in New Zealand. And basically the idea and the intention of Global Wellness Day is to live exceptionally well. So the question then becomes, well, how do we do that? Isn't that what we're trying to do? And so today we're just gonna lean into a few practices. The first one is movement. So really well established that movement makes the body live better. So we should be moving, we should be sweating, we should be balancing, we should be strengthening and doing all those good things for ourselves. We're gonna get some meditation in today. Meditation you can think of as just coming home to the essential nature of oneself. It's a simplification, it's an easing of life, and it feels really good. And we'll do a bit of breath work. So Adarha actually translates to in the presence of divine breath. And breath as an entry into, of course, you know, good energy in ourselves, but also into presence. And then after all that good stuff, we'll probably sign off here, but I invite you to practice a couple of more key pillars to wellness. One of those is community. So we've gathered here today and we're gonna celebrate by having a bit of a cashew nut latte, a chai latte. And I hope you can grab something delicious and healthy that doesn't include a hangover, and maybe a friend, or maybe a stranger, or maybe a loved one, and spend some time together afterwards. Community is the number one thing that we can do to live a good, healthy, and long life. So let's get started. Woo!
All right. Welcome, gang. Nice to see you all. Nice to see a full room. So this the idea of Global Wellness Day is, at least for me personally, it's quite a big kind of thing to wrap my head around. Like wellness of the globe is quite an expansive idea, and at times it can feel a little bit paralyzing to me. Like, what can little me do to influence the wellness of the globe, right? And as I was contemplating this, I came to this idea that what we really do is we start with ourselves, and if we want to expand out, we first contract in and explore that polarity of seeing what's in our center and how can we take care of ourselves in order to then take care of our families and then our small communities and then our countries, and we keep expanding. That's part of the intention behind what we're going to do today and how we're going to practice. From the yogic perspective, the seat of ourselves, the little spark of the potential of who we can be when we wake up on the right side of the bed and we make all the right decisions and we're kind and compassionate, is this little flame that sits in the center of the heart. It's called Vishokchortir. And the culmination of this practice will be a meditation exploring this little flame, you know, in whichever way you experience it. As with a lot of the yogic philosophy, it's very, kind of metaphorical and beautiful in nature. So that's where we're headed. And we'll start by harmonizing together. All right, so find a comfortable seat. If you're not comfortable, make an adjustment. And if it feels all right, shut down the eyes. Or just look down maybe at the top of your mat to soften the gaze. And begin with checking in physically and taking a noticing of the connection points of your body onto the mat. And certain areas of the body will hold a little bit more weight than others. from the body, start to tune in with the breath and gently deepen the breath. It's feeling like you're sipping in a little bit more air with the next inhale and fully exhaling with the next exhale. And then checking in with the mental body, just where is the thought process? Is there a little bit of a lag of your mind coming into practice, or are you here? We'll begin with chanting the mantra Om 3 times. Take an inhale to clear the breath. And inhale for Om. Feeling that subtle. All right, and so to get started, I'll spin you around. Lie on your back, head facing the front of the room, please. So if it's comfortable with the body, lie the legs out flat. If it feels a bit sticky on the low back, you can also bend the knees and bring the feet flat on the mat. And start with the palms down by the sides, palms facing down. And in the first few rounds of breath, I just want to introduce you to a technique called pure breathing that we'll use throughout the practice. And just to get a feel for it here lying down, as you next inhale, feel like the inhale is coming up into the upper chest, so the collarbones spread wide, the breastbone lifts a little bit, and you feel the air come up into the upper lobes of the lungs. And then with the exhale, it's driven by the belly button moving down towards the spine, so this little natural gentle contraction of the abdomen and a little bit of activation to the low back. So just take 2 more breaths like that, pure breathing, inhales up into the chest, expansive and activating, and the exhales contracting the belly button down towards the spine. And now we're going to add some movement with that. So wherever you are, go ahead and empty out your breath cycle and take an exhale here. And then as you inhale, rainbow your arms up towards the sky, and then ultimately the back of the hands come all the way towards the wood behind your mat, reaching towards the front of the room. Yep, just like that. And as you exhale, hands drop down by the sides, palms facing down, that big rainbow sweep down. Good. So a few more like that, and move with your own cycle of breath now. So as you inhale, the arms come up and back, and continue to tune into this pure breathing, and this motion will help it happen. So the inhales are into the upper chest, the exhales a little bit of an engagement, of the abdomen. Last one coming up. And the next time the hands drop down by the sides, go ahead and pause there. And bend the knees, bring the feet flat on the mat, feet about hip distance apart, and walk the heels back in towards the glutes. Setting up for a few rounds of dynamic bridge, the arms will do the same thing. As you next inhale, rise the arms up and also rise the hips up towards the sky. And then same thing here, hips down and hands down as you exhale and feel that little bit of a contraction to the low belly. So please do two more like that. And notice that the breastbone and the chin get a little bit closer towards one another as you inhale and rise. And as you exhale, you'll get an engagement to low belly and low back. Last one coming up. Really nice. So the next time hips and hands are down, pause for a moment. Moving into a static bridge now. So rise the hips up to the sky, keep the hands where they are. So one option is to stay here. Another option is to interlace your hands palm to palm underneath the sacrum. Yeah. If the hands are interlaced, you might walk the shoulders in towards one another to allow the chest to shine up a little bit easier. And we'll take about 5 breaths here, sticking with this theme of pure breathing. So once we're in a shape, the shape's not going anywhere, so we can take it, our attention one level more subtle, which would be into the breath. And last inhale coming up, stick with your round of breathing, and then the next exhale, release the hands and the hips down to the mat, and take a moment to pause and receive the pose. And just a light attention, a light concentration at the center of the chest, home of this light, the spiritual heart. Yeah, now go ahead and bring the hands out in a big cross shape or a cactus shape. You might need to negotiate a little bit of room with your neighbor. And keep the arms where they are and draw the knees into the chest so the heels come off of the ground. Take an inhale here, and then as you exhale, drop your knees off to the left, about halfway over to the mat. And then your next inhale will bring the knees back through center. And we'll alternate sides so the knees go to the right as you exhale, and you might look left. And continue to cycle back and forth a few more each round. So every inhale, you come through center, and then knees drop left and gently look to the right if it feels okay for the neck. Good. Okay, then the next time the knees drop over to the left, we'll drop the knees all the way down. And you might need to shimmy the hips a little bit over to the right to line up the spine. Sometimes that will feel intuitively nice. An option is to bring the left hand down to the outer right knee. And spend a few breaths here in the twist and feeling that gentle pressure into the abdomen. And moving back through center and over to the other side. Dropping both knees off to the right, adjusting the hips as you need. Moving back through center, and then drop both knees into the chest. hands to the upper shins. You can circle the knees together to massage into the low back, or you might circle the knees independent of one another to open up into the hips, anything that feels good. Ultimately, we're gonna come into an all fours position facing the front of the room. So if you wanna rock and roll on the spine a few times, you're welcome to do that. If you want just to roll off to the side and come to all fours, do that as well. Okay, so showing up hands and knees. Take a look down at your hands. Make sure all five fingers are spread really nice and wide. Wrists stacked underneath the shoulders, knees underneath hips. Start with cat-cow pose. As you inhale, belly down, chest up. As you exhale, tuck the tailbone, tuck the chin. Back of the heart to the sky. And continue to cycle like that with your own breath. And you'll notice that you'll move slightly slower or faster than those around you. Just tuning into that expansive quality of the inhale and that contracting quality of the exhale. And just one more round, back and forth. After this next cycle, then come into a neutral position, all fours, toes tucked under. Take an inhale, look just off the front of the mat. As you exhale, downward facing dog, hips move up and back. And keep the knees nice and bent to elongate the spine. And as you next inhale, come back forward to all fours. Look off the front of the mat. Feel that core engagement that happens as the knees touch down, and then downward facing dog as you exhale. And in your own time, cycle through that a few more times. So every inhale, you come down to all fours, looking just off the front of the mat to open up the collarbones a little bit, and then downward facing dog with the exhale. Really nice, really nice. Two more like that. Good, and then we'll meet in a down dog the next time you get there. Yeah, nice. And feel free to pedal out the heels a little bit here, sway the hips side to side. You might feel into the side of the body slightly. Good. And from here, look in between the hands, step in between the hands, forward fold. On your next inhale, lift up halfway. Take your time, long spine. Fold as you exhale. Do that one more time. Just feel into the back turning on. Fold with the exhale. And next inhale, come up to stand. Reach the hands up over the head. And the hands down by the sides. Just make sure you're at the front of your mat. Inhale, rise the hands up. Fold as you exhale. Lift halfway, inhale, and then step the right foot back. Right knee drops down to the mat. Rise the torso. Okay, this first round of these few rounds of flow, just a little bit of a bounce into this hip. So you'll feel into the front of the right hip, maybe left groin a little bit. Good. And find something that looks like stillness and inhale the fingertips up towards the sky, heart up towards the sky, gentle lift of the gaze. Then hands come down, frame the front foot. Step forward, forward fold. Interlace the hands behind the sacrum like a bridge setup. Roll the shoulders forward, drop the hands up over the head towards the front of the room. Open the front of the shoulders. And then inhale to stand up. Release the interlace, rise the hands up over the head, slightly gaze up. Hands down through center and down by the sides. Stay with the breath. Inhale, rise the hands up. Fold, exhale. Half lift, inhale. Left foot steps back. Left knee drops down. Inhale, rise, torso up. A little bit of a pulse here. Finding stillness. Take an inhale to extend. Exhale, hands to the front of the mat. Step forward, forward fold. Interlace hands behind the sacrum. Open up the front of the shoulders. Drop the hands forward. Beautiful. And then take an inhale to stand you up. Reach the hands up over the head. Long through both side bodies. Hands down through center and down by the side. Okay, one more each round. We'll flow one movement for each breath. Inhale and rise the hands up. Fold, exhale. Half lift, inhale. Step the right foot back. Right knee drops down, inhale, rise. Stillness as you exhale. Fingertips to the sky as you inhale. Hands frame front foot, step forward, forward fold. Take your time here, find that interlace behind the sacrum and open up the front of the shoulders a little bit. And then once you found one, exhale and then rise with an inhale, stand up, reach the hands up over the head. Yeah, get as tall as you've gotten all day, really stretch. Nice. Hands through center, down by the side. Last round, inhale, rise hands. If you feel like you know where you're going, just go. I'll still cue it, fold as you exhale. Your inhale will lift you up halfway. And then step the left foot back. As you exhale, left knee can drop down and use the inhale to rise the torso. And then find stillness and grounding as you exhale. Good. Find length through the spine as you inhale. And then hands frame the front foot. Step forward, forward fold. Take your time here to find the interlace of the hands behind the sacrum. Drop the hands over towards the front of the room. Nice. And then inhale to rise up. Hands through center and down by the sides. We'll pause here, mountain pose. Hands either at heart center or down by the side. You can close the eyes down if you'd like or just gaze out in front of you. And feel as though you're not just standing tall through the crown of the head, but standing tall through the heart as well. So just a proud stance. The mat, take a step back with your right foot, so that's a warrior two type of shape. So right foot steps back. Awesome. Arms out to the side. Okay. Start by straightening the front leg. Take an inhale. And then exhale, bend left knee, left elbow to left knee, right arm reaches up and over, side angle. So dynamically in between these two a few times. So inhale, rise back up, warrior one, or warrior two, straighten the front leg. Nice. Then bend left knee, left elbow, left knee, right arm reaches up and over, side angle. So two more like that. Inhale, rises you up. Exhale, side angle. So notice lengthening right side body as you dive in and strengthening side body as you come back out. And last one coming up. Okay, now keep the body completely still. Stay here for the inhale. As you exhale, bring the back of the right hand to the right hip. Good. And inhale, sweep the right hand up and over the head. Back to side angle. Good. Again, like that. So exhale, right hand, right hip. Inhale, big sweep of the top arm up and over. Good. Last one coming up. Sweep. Now stay still, physically completely still. Return to pure breathing. Okay, option to grow those left fingertips down towards the mat inside the left foot. And then where we be still, another three breaths or so. Inhales up into the chest and right side rib. Exhales, stabilize with drawing the belly button back towards the spine. Leaning into that little bit of heat and challenge. Good. Look down if you're not looking down already and inhale up and out of the pose. Straighten the front leg for a moment. Good. Then windmill the arms to frame that front foot. Step back into a high plank. Okay, with or without knees, lower down. Take a baby cobra, lift the chest, breathe up into the upper lungs. Chest back down towards the mat, downward facing dog. three breaths, down dog. So our ability to be still and stable directly impacts our ability to show up for those in our communities around us, being a grounded pillar. So notice that there's a bit of challenge in being physically still, and that's all right. It's part of the work. Step your right foot in between your hands, setting up for warrior two, right foot forward. Rise up. If you need to adjust your stance a bit, do that. Start with the front leg straight, arms out by the sides. Good. Take an inhale here, extend the spine. As you exhale, bend right knee, right elbow, right knee, side angle, left arm reaches up and over. And then your inhale rises you up and out. Beautiful. Exhale, side angle. Two more like that. This one coming up. Okay, body still. Stay for the inhale. Reach through the left fingertips. As you exhale, back of the left hand to the left hip. Big sweeping inhale, left hand up and over, side angle. Beautiful. A few more like that. Exhale, hand brings down by the side. Use the physical pose to bring a little bit more air up into the left side lung. Good. Last one coming up. Next time, the left arm's extended towards the front of the room. Pause here. If you want to grow those right fingertips down towards the ground, you can. And then let's cultivate this attitude of stability. Pure breathing. Inhales up into the chest. Exhales, belly button back towards the spine. Almost there. Good. Look down to release the neck. Windmill up. To release the pose, you can release that front leg, straightening it. Good. And then windmill the arms down to frame the right foot. Step back. High plank. With or without knees, lower yourself down. Cobra, lifting the chest. Downward facing dog. 3 to 4 breaths, down dog. And noticing that you can still tune into that pure breathing and even in this pose. So you can breathe into the upper chest and upper back a little bit as you inhale. Good, almost there. And look in between the hands, step in between the hands, forward fold. Take an inhale and a halfway lift and a fold on your exhale. And then come up to stand on your next inhale. Reach the hands up over the sky. Hands down by the sides. So once again, step back with your right foot, setting up warrior one this time around. So feeling like your feet are about hip distance apart. So there's quite a solid base there. Hips are moving towards the front of the mat. They might not get there, but they're trying. Okay. Front leg starts straight. Bring the hands down by the sides, palms facing backwards. As you inhale, bend left knee, bring the hands up and then out to the sides like you're holding two dishes with your hands. Chest will open. And exhale, straighten the front leg and bring the hands down by the sides. Good. Again, bend front knee, inhale up and out. Good. And exhale, straighten front leg, hands down by the side. Two more. And I'll keep the lower body as it is and keep the hands circling so they interlace behind the sacrum once again. Roll the shoulders back and open the front of the chest. Gaze out in front of you and develop your focus here. Now the invitation for just a gentle hold of the breath at the top of your inhale. So as we're here for the next 3 to 5 breaths, just as you inhale up into the chest, just a 1 second little pause of the breath. And use the center of your chest as almost an object of meditation, just putting your mind there, particularly when the breath's held just for a moment. Last breath coming up. Nice, and then release the interlock. Come to step forward to the front of the mat. Pause, hands down by the sides, pull through the chest. Feeling the breath. Knowing that this expansion and contraction is happening constantly as we breathe out, the earth breathes in. As the earth breathes out, we breathe in. This constant exchange. Left foot steps back. Warrior one set up. Take time to get the lower body tuned in. Hands down by the sides, front leg straight. Inhale, bend the right knee, bring the hands up. And slightly out, open the chest. Exhale, straighten front leg, hands down by the side. Still tuning into this pure breathing. So the inhales come up into the chest and the pose will help you do that. And the exhales, a little bit of a core engagement. And 2 more coming up. Okay, so lower body stays still, keep circling the arms so they interlace behind the sacrum. Find a comfortable position, rolling the shoulders back, chest forward, gaze forward. And the pose isn't going anywhere, so focus on the breath. The invitation is there for a gentle hold of the breath at the top of the inhale. Last breath coming up. As you next exhale, take your time, release the interlace, step up to the front of the mat. Pause here for a moment and receive. As the hands up to the sky, get tall through both side bodies, fold forward with your exhale. Downward facing dog, step back. And roll forward to a high plank, lower your belly all the way down to the mat so you're lying flat. And take a moment here. Let the arms, the head, the legs do whatever they want to do to feel comfortable for a handful of breaths. So then now with that physical heart space pressed down into the mat, tuning into how the breath will expand up and out three-dimensionally, feeling into the upper back, the back door of the heart. We're gonna drop into a back bend 2 different ways. So one with our active range of motion and one with more of a passive range of motion. So we'll all go active first. So start by bending your knees and bring your toes up to the sky. Yeah, nice. Interlace the hands behind the sacrum like we've been doing. Cool. As you next inhale, lift everything up that you can lift up. So your toes, your knees, it'll feel like you're kind of punching back through your calves, that's the word, and then bring everything down with an exhale. I couldn't find my word and I just kept you up there while I searched for the word calf. Okay, here we go. I got calf now, so we'll be more on. Okay, so now do that three more times. So inhale, rise up, and then your exhale will lower you down. Okay, so do that two more times and notice the low back and the glutes being quite involved as you do this. And just take kind of note that this is your active range of motion to lift your body into a belly down back bend. Last one coming up. Nice. Okay, so then relax for a moment. And then we're going to come into the static pose, bow pose. If it's accessible, grab the outside of your ankles. If it's not accessible to grab the outside of the ankles, do the version we just did. Okay. And we'll hold now for about 5 breaths. So gather your focus. And as you next inhale, lift everything up again. Okay. To lift the lower body more, rise the wrists towards the ceiling. And to lift the upper body more, kick back into your hands. Nice. Okay. Keep breathing. So if you ever find that you start holding the breath, then just release early. And again, feel those inhales come up into the upper chest. Beautiful. Last inhale coming up. And then on your exhale, gently release back down. Again, legs, arms, head, do whatever they want to do to feel comfortable. And just notice the natural internalizing rebound we get from the back bend. Breathing. Good, and then carefully push back to a child's pose. Breathing. Go ahead and walk the torso up. Sit down with your legs extended out in front of you. Bend your right knee. Bring your right foot flat on the mat. This will be a seated twist. Right foot outside left knee. Cool. So one option is to stay here. I'm going to ask you to twist from here. Another option is to roll to your left. Swing your left foot by your right glute. Just an option. One might feel a little bit more natural than the other. Wherever you end up, interlace on the front of the knee and sit up nice and tall. And right hand behind you, left hand to the sky, extend the spine, and then twist to your right. You can either hug that front knee or cross the elbow on the other side of the knee. I'll switch you around, yeah. Great. Our gaze can be either out to the side of the room or over the right shoulder. If it feels comfortable, we can shut down the eyes and from here on out, we're gonna kind of leave that pure breathing, and now you'll feel a more natural inkling for abdominal breath in this pose. stillness, and then go ahead and look forward to release the neck and unwind the body, just one breath in between. And both legs can extend out in front of you. Left knee into the chest, left foot flat on the mat. Left foot over right knee. Same two options here. You can swing that right foot around if you'd like. And it's worth taking the time. The spine loves to be extended, then twists. So sit up nice and tall, left hand behind you, right hand reaches up, and twist to your left, either hugging the knee or cross the elbow on the other side of the knee. The first breath or two, feel free to fidget a little bit to just readjust the spine to be tall and sort out where you like your gaze, either out to the side of the room or over the left shoulder. And tune into that expansion and contraction of the abdomen as it might press up against the left upper thigh. Looking forward to release the neck and untwist the body, your breath, neutral. And both legs extend out in front of you. Two options here. One is to have the legs extended. If you have to tighten the back of the body, bend the knees is quite nice, or soles of the feet together, which will take the hamstrings out of it. Either is fine. Wherever you end up, sit up nice and tall. And exhale and fold in. The spine will round a little bit, that's all good, but see if you can keep some integrity into the upper chest. We've done a bit of opening into the chest, so don't round too much. Check in with the back of the neck. It's long and relaxed. Breath down into the belly. Do your best to use the strength of your spine to lift you up, training those spinal extensor muscles. Yeah, you can come on up out of the pose. Just a moment to pause. And then we'll set up for Shavasana. I'll spin you around, so head face the front of the room, down on your back. The sensing or feeling that the spine is aligned and that there's symmetry as best you can in both sides of the body. Hands either down by the sides, palm facing up to help that natural opening to the chest we've been working on, or hands on the body is perfectly fine as well. And before you let the breath go completely effortless, start by taking 5 abdominal breaths, feeling belly button rise towards the sky as you inhale and fall towards the spine as you exhale. Once those 5 breaths are complete, then allow the breath to adjust back to a natural rhythm, no efforts. And I'll let you know when we're coming up for our seated practice. begin to come back to the breath. Allow the next inhale and exhale to have a little bit more effort for them. And breathe a little bit of movement into the fingers, the toes, and any other movement that feels helpful. Option for a full body stretch, reaching the hands, and extending through the legs and the arms. On your way up to a seat, you're welcome to roll off to one side and take a few breaths in the recovery position there. So as we set up to sit, know that we'll sit for somewhere in the range of 10 minutes or so. So usually propping up your hips is helpful. And another subtlety in here is that if we can just stagger ourselves so you can do this and not touch the person next to you. Just a little negotiation, forward, back, forward, back. Nice. Great. So as part of the meditation that we're going to practice tonight, there's going to be a mudra involved, and I'll just show you visually. So then once we're there, if you feel like keeping your eyes closed, you can. So the hands will be at heart center, and I'll cue you into all of this, but the hands will rise up and then out towards the sides of the room, palms facing up, and the hands will come back towards center. Okay. So for now, the hands can rest on the knees or in the lap, anywhere comfortable. And again, if it feels all right, you can shut down the eyes or just soften the gaze down in front of you. The breath technique we're going to be practicing tonight is called Viloma. We're going to be separating our inhale into three separate compartments, and then it'll be a smooth, continuous exhale. I'll talk through one, and then I'll guide you through a few. So we'll go as follows. Inhale a third of your capacity, hold the breath. Inhale another third, hold the breath. Inhale a final third, hold the breath. And then a slow, continuous exhale. As we've been doing, those inhales will be focused up into the chest, and really put your mind there to enhance technique. So take an inhale to clear the breath. And inhale a third of your capacity. Hold. Another third. Hold. Final third. Hold. And a smooth exhale. And again, inhale a third. Hold. Another third, hold, final third, hold, smooth exhale. So continue like this for another handful of rounds of breath. With the intention of all three of these segments of inhales being the exact same length, the exact same feeling in the body, and even the exact same internal sound. once these three segments of breath are becoming more and more similar, the mental component of this technique is on the breath hold in the chest, feeling or seeing or imagining a small light, a small flame in the center of the chest. Allow this round to be your last. The end of the next exhale. Allow the breath to adjust back to a natural rhythm. Keeping the attention in the space of the chest. And seeing or feeling or visualizing a perfectly still lake filling the space of the heart and the spine to the breastbone, the rib cage, perfectly still blue lake. And floating in the center of that lake is a single candle flame. You may see it, you may hear it, you may feel it. It'll all be slightly different. The attention maintained on that flame, bring the hands together in front of the heart. As you next inhale, rise the hands up and then separate the hands, bring them out to the sides of the room, slightly lift the chin and hold the breath at the top of the inhale. As you exhale, bring the hands back in front of the heart, chin parallel to the ground. And doing that again, inhale, rising the hands up and then out, slightly lift the chin, holding the breath and feeling the light of that flame expand. And as you exhale, everything comes back towards the center line. Continuing to move and visualize in this way, every time you inhale, this light of this candle flame expands to fill the heart space. As you exhale, it contracts back to its original size. Continuing to move and breathe in your own way, a gentle pause of the breath at the top of the inhale. Light filling the space of the heart. As you continue to practice, notice that this expansion of light can reach down the inner arms into the hands, fingertips. Each time you exhale, that light contracts back to original form. And as you continue to practice, notice that the boundaries of the physical body may blur as that light expands out and starts interacting with those around you in the space. And with that step, you might notice that the walls of the Araha room become blurry as well, and this light has a limitless expansive quality. Each exhale, though, experiencing it all gather back to a single point in the center of the chest. These next few rounds, don't let the mind limit you as this expansion reaches. And these final few rounds, start drawing it back. Feeling that expansion expand from the Wakatipu Basin back into the Araha room. And then that expansion move back into the fingertips. And that light fill the heart space. And allow this next exhale to be your last as the hands come back to center and it all pulls back into a single candle flame in the center of the heart. And then allow the hands to drop down into the lap, palms facing up. Experience any leftover pulsation. For the next few minutes, use this light of the heart, Vishok Jyotir, as your anchor, your object to focus your attention on. Notice when you heard the word notice, was there a train of thought? If there was, just without attaching to it, bid it farewell. and make that journey back home to yourself, center of the spiritual heart. Effortlessness is the ability to slow down and listen for the spaces between the thoughts. Deep within all things, there is a natural rhythm, a music of opening and closing, expansion and contraction. The hands once again together in front of the heart. And space here for a piece of internal gratitude for the heart, for when the heart leads and the intellect follows. Close our practice with three rounds of the mantra Om. Take an inhale to clear the breath. And in for Om. For the heart. Feel that settle. Option to rub a little bit of heat into the palms. Once you feel some heat, then cupping the closed eyes with the palms and feeling that heat transfer, and you can blink the eyes into the closed palms, slowly letting some light back in, coming back into the room. Namaste. And I was like, namaste. For everyone at home practicing, thanks so much for tuning in. Yeah, you can tune in with Global Wellness Day through the links that we'll post. And if you enjoyed practicing with us, we're coming to you again for International Yoga Day on the 21st of June, right here in the Adarha Room. Sending love.